going to do the grain size distribution of the given soil sample. Here for grain size distribution, we can also call it as sieve analysis. Means the how we are going to sieve the soil sample from arranging the inner standard sieves. Coming to the aim, it is called as to determine the grain size distribution of given soil sample. What are the apparatus we are going to use to conduct sieve analysis? That is grain size distribution. We are going to use inner standard sieves of different sizes. Inner standard sieves of starting from 4.75 mm, 2.3x, 1.18, 600 till 1.18 it will be in mm. Next 600 micron, 300 micron, 150 micron, 75 micron and pan. These are the different inner standard sieves which we are going to use for conducting the sieve analysis. That is grain size distribution of given soil sample. Next, here again, whenever the soil is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, whatever the soil that is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, that is called as gravel. Again, whatever the soil is between 4.75 mm to 0.0. Initially, we are going to take the 500 grams of soil sample. Whatever the 500 grams of soil sample, we are going to place it on the 4.75 mm sieve. After placing on the 4.75 mm sieve, we are going to keep the sieves in the sieve shaker machine. After taking 500 grams soil sample in the 4.75 mm sieve, we are going to start the sieve shaker machine. And we are going to shake for 5 to 10 minutes. Based upon the soil sample, we are going to shake it for 5 to 10 minutes. And after the soil is sieved, we are going to collect the soil sample from each sieve. Soil sample, these are the soils which are retained on different sieves. First of all, initially, whatever the soil that is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, you have to take. Soil retained on 4.75 mm sieve is about 31 grams. Here, we can consider this as whatever the soil which is retained on 4.75 mm sieve is as gravel, and whatever the soil which is between 4.75 mm to 0.075 micron, that is sand. And whatever the, if the 50% of soil is retained on 75 micron sieve, it is called as coarse grain sand. And if the 50% of soil is passed through 75 micron sieve, means if the 50% of soil is passed through 75 micron sieve, it is called as fine sand. And whatever the soil that is settled in the pan, means below 75 micron sieve, whatever the soil is settled, that is known as silt and clay. Here, coming to the sieve analysis calculations, first of all, as we have done the experiment and we have taken the soils which are retained on 4.75 mm sieve, 2.36, 1.18, 600 micron, 300 micron, 150 micron, 75 micron and in the pan. First of all, whatever the soil which is retained on 4.75 mm sieve is 86 grams. In the similar way, whatever the soil that is retained on 2.36 mm is 92 grams, and the soil retained on 1.18 grams is 114 grams, and the soil retained on 600 micron sieve is 135 grams, and the soil retained on 300 micron sieve is 66 grams, and the soil retained on 150 micron sieve is 6 grams, and the soil retained on 0.075 sieve is 0.2 grams, and the soil which is passed through 0.75 mm sieve, that is which is retained on pan, which is settled in the pan, is 0.8 grams. This is the weight of soil retained on different sieves. Now we are going to calculate the percentage weight of soil retained. Percentage weight of soil retained will be depending upon, as we have taken total weight of a soil sample as, total weight as, that is W is equal to 500 grams we have taken the soil sample, weight of soil sample. Now, weight of soil, percentage weight of soil retained on 4.75 mm sieve, we are going to calculate. That is 86 divided by 500 into 100. By this we can calculate, that is 5 into 17.2, that is 86 grams. Here we got as 17.2. In the similar way, for 2.36 grams, what is the percentage weight of soil retained? That is 18.4. That is 92 divided by 500 into 100. In the similar way, 114 divided by 500 into 100. 135 divided by 500 into 100. Similarly, 0.8 divided by 500 into 100. We will get it as 22.8, 27, 13.2, 1.2, 0.04 and 0.16. Now we have completed the percentage weight of soil retained. Now we are going to calculate what is the cumulative percentage weight of soil retained. Cumulative means we have to add what are the above values. First one it will be 17.2. 17.2 plus 18.4, it will be 35.6. 35.6 plus 22.8, we got it as 58.4. 58.4 plus 27, that is 85.4. Next, 85.4 plus 13.2, we got it as 98.6. 98.6 plus 1.2, that is 99.8. 99.8 plus 0.04, 99.84. And finally, 99.84 plus 0.6. Finally, we will get as 100. This is the 100% soil that is retained. Means we have taken the 500 grams at the initial and at last. By calculating all the weights, we got 500 grams. Means no percent, no soil is gone out of the sieves. Means no soil is wasted. Here, we have to calculate the percentage final. Percentage final, how we are going to calculate? Means 100 minus cumulative percentage weight of soil retained. 100 minus 17.2, that is 82.8. In the similar way, 100 minus 35.6, we are going to get it as 64.4. Similarly, 100 minus 58.4, that is 41.6. 100 minus 85.4, 14.6. 100 minus 98.6, 1.4. 100 minus 99.8, 0.2. 100 minus 99.84, that is 0.16. At last, 100 minus 100 will be 0. Here we have calculated what are the results. Next, what are the formulas we are going to use for in the grain size distribution? That is formulas whatever we are going to use means. First one is the coefficient of curvature. It is coefficient of curvature. Coefficient of curvature will be represented by CC. Coefficient of curvature CC is equal to D30 square by D60 into D10. In a similar way, how we are going to calculate coefficient of uniformity, that is coefficient of uniformity CU is equal to D60 by D10. Where we can say that here D60 means the diameter of soil particle at 60% finer, and D30 represents the diameter of soil particle at 30% finer, and D10 represents the diameter of soil particle at 10% finer. Next, soil is classified into different categories. First of all, in the initial, soil is classified into coarse grained soil. Whenever it is more than 0.075 mm soil particles, it is called as coarse grained soil. Again, coarse grained soil is further divided into gravel and sand. Whenever the soil is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, it is called as gravel. And whatever the soil is retained, whatever the soil is placed between 0.075 mm and to 4.75 mm, it is called as sand. And sand is further divided into coarse sand, medium sand and fine sand. Whenever the soil is varying from 4.75 mm to 2 mm, it is called as coarse sand. And whenever the soil is retained between 2 mm to 0.425 mm, it is called as medium sand. And whenever the soil is placed between, means whenever the soil is retained between 0.075 and 0.425 mm, it is called as fine sand. In this, we are going to calculate coarse grained, fine sand and medium sand. Again, in the fine grained soil means whenever the soil is passed through 0.075 mm is more than 50%. Means if more than 50% of soil is passed through 0.075 mm, it is called as fine sand. That is fine grained soil. Again, further fine grained sand is further divided into silt and clay. Silt means whenever the soil is less than 0.002 mm, it is called as silt. And coming to the clay, whenever the soil is less than 0.002 mm, silt means whenever the soil is greater than 0.002 mm, it is called as silt. In the similar way, compared to the clay, whenever the soil is below 0.002 mm, it is called as clay. Next, further we are going for do calculations. Whatever the soil retained on differences, we are going to do calculations based on that particular values, whatever we have been regarded during the test. Coming to the calculations, in the theoretical part, first of all we need to calculate what are the percentage of gravel. We have to go by increasing to decreasing, that is gravel, sand, silt, clay. Means in the gravel, as already we said, whatever the soil that is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, whatever the soil that is retained on 4.75 mm sieve, that is 86. 86 divided by 500, total weight of the soil into 100 per percentage, we will get 17.2%. In the similar way for sand, as we have said, for sand, soil will be retained from below 4.75 mm to above 0.075 mm. That we are going to calculate. That is 86 below 4.75 mm. 92 plus 114 plus 135 plus 66 plus 6 plus 0.2. Soil between 2.36 to 0.075. Less than 4.75 mm. Less than 4.75 mm and above 0.075 mm. That is 92 plus 114 plus 135 plus 66 plus 6 plus 0.2 divided by, in the similar way, total weight of the soil sample, that is 500 into 100 for percentage final. Here we, after doing calculation, we are getting it as 82.64%. What are the soil that is retained on, means what are the percentage of sand that is present in the particular soil sample, that is percentage of sand as 82.64. Next we are going to calculate percentage finer. Percentage finer means below 0.75 mm, below 0.075 mm, whatever the soil is passed away. That is, whatever the soil that is retained on the pan, that is 0.8 grams. 0.8 divided by total weight of the soil sample into 100. We are going to get it as 0.16%. Here from the calculations we got percentage gravel as 17.2% and percentage of sand as 82.64. And percentage finer is 0.16, that is fine sand is 0.16%. Again, whenever the CU is greater than 4, it will be called as well graded gravel. Again, whenever the CU is greater than 6, it is called as well graded sand. That is, coefficient of uniformity is greater than 6 means well graded sand. Again, whenever it lies between 1 cc to 3, it is called as well graded soil, well graded gravel, well graded sand and well graded soil. This will be useful in the viva, whenever we are going to do viva, whenever you are going to face viva, these questions will be useful. Cu, cc and that is coefficient of uniformity, coefficient of curvature, based upon using formulas. Cu is equal to d60 by d10 and c. Again, after the calculations, what are the results we got? We are going to draw a graph for this grain size distribution, that is for particle size versus percentage finer. In the rough format, I am drawing first of all, that is particle size will be represented in mm on x-axis. And the percentage finer will be represented on y-axis. Here, based upon the above point, that is Cu, Cc, we are going to draw the graph. That is, based upon using formula, that is Cu is equal to d60 by d10. And Cc is equal to d30 square by d60 into d10. This d10, d30 and d60 we are going to get from this graph. What are the particle size and percentage finer? From these values, we are going to attain particle size and percentage finer. For 4.75 mm, what is the percentage finer? For 2.36, what is the percentage finer? In the similar way, for 0.075 mm, what is the percentage finer? That we are going to draw the graph. For D10, D30, D60. Initially, I will draw the rough format of the graph, and later I will show you the graph in semi-logarithmical graph. Here, this is the detailed diameter of particle of 10% finer, 30% finer, and 60% finer. This is the particle size distribution curve. Now, when we draw the graph based upon that values, the graph is going to be like this as a semi-log graph by plotting the values. That is, for percentage finer and particle size, sieve size from 4.75 to 0.075 mm, and particle size will be varying from 0 to 100. We will be getting graph like this. This is the semi-logarithmic graph. Based upon this graph, we are going to get D10 value, D30 value, and D60 value. D10 value is, here we got from the graph, from semi-logarithm graph, we will get D10 value as 0.49 mm and D30 value as 0.98 mm and D60 value as 2.2 mm. Next, we have to calculate quotient of uniformity, that is Cu. As already we know, Cu is equal to D60 by D10. D60 is 2.2 by D10, 0.49. We will get approximately 4.489. It means approximately it will be 4.5. Next, we want to know quotient of curvature. What is the quotient of curvature? Cc. Cc is equal to D30 square by D60 into D10. D30, we got it as 0.98 into 0.98 by D60, 2.2 into 0.49, we will get as 0.89, approximately we can take it as 0.9. Here, whenever the Cu is greater than 6 and Cc is not in between 1 and 3. The soil sample can be graded as Cc is not in between 1 and 3, the soil sample can be graded as poorly graded soil. Next, from the graph, whatever the graph we got, we are going to find out what are the percentage gravel. Percentage gravel is equal to 100, that is total cumulative minus 82.5. That is 17.5% from the graph. Next, percentage of coarse sand. That will be 82.5 minus 58.5. We will get 24%. And percentage of medium sand, 58.5 minus 7, we will get as 51.5%. And fine sand, that is 7 minus 0.16, we will get it as 6.84%. And finally, percentage finer, we will get it as 0.16%. And later, after calculating Cu, Cc, we are going to do the results. Coming to the results, results part. As already we have said, the soil sample can be graded as poorly graded soil. By doing the grain size distribution of sieve analysis, we are going to determine either the soil is well graded, uniformly graded, or poorly graded, or gap graded. Here, compared to the results which we got, the given soil is poorly graded soil sample. which will be represented as SP, that is poorly graded soil sample. With this we have completed the grain size distribution for determining the C1 lysis.